My dear brothers and sisters, when I come in front of you, I almost feel like the clock should be wound back some 50 years ago, because I think that someone will feel very comfortable in those white and red pullovers.
It's true.
When they were singing the Lord of Mercy and the song, the only thing I miss is that instead of very sharp, shrill voices, you can be loud. We now have some great singing pieces. And instead of this small thing that I'm about to hear, we have a huge man in front of me.
Cannot be
and
that.
I see why they put a lot of cross on my head.
Exactly.
And it is like one of those problems when they have the house visited.
Yeah, of course.
With the only exception that the stairs on this side are not on my way. Because if they were, then they would have been trouble. I know that it's always a pleasure coming together as students of SaHeCo City. And there's a certain pride that the students of that college have, and everybody in Cameroon knows, it's a pride that has kept them on, it's a pride that is legitimate. A pride because they are second to none. And this with October now, with the SHESA, because I began with the SHESA and T-R-E. And those are the three letters that I'd like to share with you. T to the square. First T stands for truth. Truth. Most of you are scientists. And in the world today, there is nothing more important than the scientific truth. People are ready to go to any extent to establish a principle, a workable hypothesis, something on which humanity can build. That's why all the research in various fields of science to come to some agreement, to converge on something that can be handled. Rather ironically, at the time when there is a great desire to have this scientific truth, the academics are toying with the word truth, and for many, there exists no truth. They relativize the truth. And your opinion is just as good as my opinion. Because people insist these days on human rights. And we think that we can insist and argue on every other thing until we reach a point where nobody else knows whether we have truth or not. In fact, the philosophers today are talking about the fact that truth is how you see reality, and that there is no reality except what you conceive in your mind and live in your actual life. That is true. But if this is true, then we have ceased very, very seriously from knowing what real truth is. And if I am talking about the thread that my first thread is true to you, it is because you are ex-students of a school that has taught you to know and to propagate and to defend the truth. And in the world today, the truth seems to have very little importance. You have heard it said in the gospel that you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. And many of you have spoken the truth and ended up in trouble. And you are asking yourself, what is the meaning of this truth all about? What is this truth? You have seen people who were very honest in their life and they have never made it through in life. They are finding it difficult. They are navigating through life with difficulty. But those who are crooks and hopes seem to know how to beat their way through. And they can't be ready to this. So the temptation is, why cling to this truth? It is not only you who are asking this question. The whole world is asking questions. But as academics, we have an obligation to search the truth. As academics, we have an obligation to give the truth to the world. And the truth that you and I must give to that world is the truth that is one and indivisible. If it is true, it will be one and indivisible. Truth cannot be true. If it is truth, it is true. One plus one equals two in the state. It will remain the truth. We will agree on it. If it is the truth, one person cannot have an opposing view and claim that it is as true as the other aggressively opposing view. It cannot be true. Truth cannot be contrary to each other. It cannot contradict itself. Truth is something that unites. That's why we talk these days about convergence, the theory of convergence. Everything in humanity is trying to converge. Even those now of the digital age are trying to make a database where everybody will become just a number, where everybody will become just a recognizable figure which you type on your computer and you can recognize it. That's why I call Facebook the American database, collecting one another. There is an attempt to converge, to unite. Truth unites. will somehow, even if you decide to way of approach, you will know that what you say is objectively true. Again, people will quarrel with the word objectively true. Truth is eternal. If it is true today, it is true tomorrow, it will be true in 10 years now. If God took that from faith, that changes in your way, it is not true. That is why we never have, I hope you all know, those of you who are in the science field, that there are no principles anymore. They are working on hypotheses. Because every day they are looking for two ways of changing in order to establish something that will remain forever. So the scientists today claim this is the problem. The guy who claimed we all came by the Big Bang. After 30 years, he said no, it was something else. Sometimes he's leaving people for 30 years. He starts now saying no, it was something else. So you better be careful and understand that truth is eternal. It does not end. It cannot be true today and false tomorrow. Then it was not true. All of us must effort to understand this. And if I'm saying this is because there is truth about ourselves that many of us are rejecting. Those of you who are in the medical field know that the worst thing to have is to have a patience in denial. A patience who is refusing that this is my situation at this moment, that I have sick of cancer and that I'm going to die. The most difficult moment for any medical doctor is trying to get that patient in denial to accept the truth, the reality. There's nothing you can do about it. That's just the truth. And because we have been questioning the truth, on the 6th of August 1973, Blessed John Paul II wrote a document which I recommend that each of you will try to read. It is called Veritas Splendor Veritatis. That is the splendor of the truth. You Google, you will find it. He tried to say that there are fundamental truths in life that you cannot object. So as students and ex-students of secondary school, as ex-students of public institutions, you have a mission in the world to promote the truth, to stand by the truth, and to defend that truth. An academic is not somebody who swears by the way, who goes along with every other person. Democracy says majority wins. In academics, majority does not necessarily win. There is no harm in being. And so we can stand our ground. The truth will set you free. If it is real truth, it will set you free. Let us also accept to talk the truth to others. Because we are living in a society where some of you out of 9, 10 things that you say, 9 are lies. And we are living in a society where nobody knows what to accept from the other person. You don't know whether they are lying or they are telling the truth. This makes living a society difficult. Let us learn to speak the truth. And those of you who are fortunate or unfortunately married, if you don't tell the truth to your wife, tell the truth to no other person. Because the only service for you going to heaven is looking after that wife and children. You can look after every other person. As long as you don't look after your wife and children, that is in your mind. You will be like having prepared very well to go around chemistry by studying biology. You will fail.